Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to another episode of Wholesale Sharks podcast. In today's episode, we will be sharing the stage with Mr. Manny Serrano. Our very own Annette Seijas will be doing the interviewing. Again, if you find value from today's show, share it, like it, do what you gotta do, send us a quick message, let us know you enjoyed it. Let's get this going.
Hey, Manny, how you doing?
What's up?
Cool. So we'll go ahead and get this started. We want to welcome everybody to our live here at the Wholesale Sharks. Live with Manny at the Dispo Shark Studio. This is our podcast with him. We're going to be talking to him a little bit. How are you doing?
I'm doing amazing. How are you guys doing?
Awesome. Good. Thanks. So to start off, we want to ask you a little bit about yourself. What's going on, Manny?
Nothing much here. Working, grinding. I was just talking to Rodrigo and Ramon. Talking about the day, talking about what's next, you know, what's next in life, what's next for all this going on. It's been crazy lately for me. So I've been seeing a lot of a huge impact in my business and just things going amazing.
That's exciting. It's like, you know, once you start, you kind of just take off, right?
Yeah, it's it took me a while. I was doing deals here and there. I was like, let's say half-assing stuff, things. I was at a part-time job. I was getting part-time results. May 15th, I decided to go all in. I actually talked to Ramon before I decided to quit my 9-to-5, and man, it's been crazy. It's been a journey. Yeah.
So I'm going to ask you a few questions on the podcast. Yes. If you don't mind, we'll just go ahead and jump right into it. So how did you start in real estate? I know you said you had a part-time job before. You spoke to Rodrigo. What kind of drove you to get to go all in?
So I was in 2019, I was working at a company, and I also was flipping cars at the time.
Uh-huh.
So I go back into the car business. It's always been faithful to me.
Yeah.
Things got tough. I decided to go. I started doing side jobs, construction. I went into sales at a retail store. And I was there for like a year and a half, wanting to do this real estate wholesale thing, and it just wasn't. I was kind of going at it blindly.
Yeah.
One day this year, May 15th, I was like, F this, put my 2 weeks in. And it took since May 15th I just started seeing, like, I was doing deals here and there with a few guys, especially with Ramon and Rodrigo. They've been helping me out a lot.
Right.
And let's say, like, beginning of August is when I started seeing pretty good deals. But I've also, I had like my mindset just shifted, and I started bringing value to people who I wanted to connect with. Like, these guys are here. One thing I went to Ramon's house one time. He invited me for a pool party, and I told him, like, hey, bro, like, I appreciate you inviting me, but I know there's, because at these meetups or these events, matter of fact, I'm closing on a pretty good deal that I met at the last event with some guys I just met.
I mean, that's what our events are all about, is like networking, and that's what we want out of it, is to, you know, start making deals and actually have movement. So that's really cool.
Yeah. So, just been grinding. It did take me a few months to get, like, I was doing JVs here and there, but once my mindset just shifted is when I started seeing a difference, starting to believe in myself, and shit, you could, the sky's the limit here.
Yeah, most definitely. I mean, so now that you kind of have the ball rolling, what markets are you primarily in right now?
So I just went virtual last month.
Oh, but nice.
I was in Arizona, pretty much the whole year. Mm-hmm.
That's super cool. Do you find it a little bit more convenient? Does it work for you going more virtual?
Yeah, because I feel like I'm great at let's say closing.
Yeah.
I'm sharpening my tools with, like, my guy Ruben that's in here. He's been helping me out a lot as well. But yeah, I feel virtual is, for me, it works. It's working amazing. And also I'm thinking of, a lot of people say it's really competitive here in Arizona. So I decided to go all in here. Once shit, I become pretty good here, I'm pretty sure I could handle it anywhere else.
Yeah, most definitely. I mean, so now that you're virtual, you're making moves, what do you feel like has been the biggest challenge for you that you've faced, wholesaling and actually closing on deals?
At first, it was putting in the damn work. Like I said, half-assing shit, not really grinding, and like actually really believing in myself. Hey, can I do this? Like, you get those nights or those times where you just want to give it up, like, and you don't know what. Like, damn it, when's this deal coming? And after that first deal, shit just started rolling, and things right. like that, you know? But in all, it's just putting in the work as for me and self-belief and knowing this shit is possible.
I mean, even for myself here and us at the Dispo Studio, I mean, it requires a lot of motivation, self-motivation, and what is it? Just being consistent. Consistency, yeah. I know, is like for sure the biggest thing. It's like you're going to have to do the same thing over and over and over again. And yeah, there's those days where it's like, oh, I'm tired, but you know, you will see a result eventually for sure. And you're living proof of it, right? Because you just closed up on a deal. We helped you on a deal. I know that you made, it was what, $15,000?
Yeah.
When we helped you on?
Yeah, it was that one. Well, I've done before then. So Ramon, Rodrigo, they've helped me out with three.
Nice.
This one was one of the ones I've got since I decided to quit my 9-to-5. And yeah, at the event, I actually met, not sure if you guys, Andy and Martin. Them guys we locked up a deal virtual, and I just met them at that first event. I just connected with them, talked, and hey, I got this deal, bro. Help me out. Boom. All right, let's go. So
that's awesome.
It's going, and believing in God a lot.
Right.
My mind, but yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Shout out to Ramon. Ramon, man, this guy, I call time. He's there to answer my calls. Ramon, I told him, but hey, bro, I'm gonna be asking you, like, don't think this is just like I don't want to be those guys that just goes to every meetup and every event and don't take action. I said, like, I'm gonna bring value to you if obviously you're returning the favor to me. So I'm not gonna waste people's time and not bring value at the end of the day. And I've seen that's been a huge impact. Me attaching myself to these guys doing 6-7 figures a month.
Right.
Because I told him, this is a matter of time for me.
So now that, I mean, you've known the struggle, you're mm-hmm. closing on deals and everything like that, what would you tell somebody that's barely getting into wholesaling? I mean, starting from the bottom, they're attending events, but they're not seeing any result. You know, what would you tell somebody that's barely starting?
Going all in. Fucking burn your bridges, no plan B, believe in yourself, and every day I network, connect, but most importantly, put in that work.
Right. I mean, it's as cliche as it is, like, you know, networking and building relationships. I really think that that's like the foundation of this business is you just, you could have one conversation and then boom, that's your first deal. Right. Yeah. So that's awesome. And I mean, like you said, you met that one person at our last event and yeah. that was your deal for you. So that's really cool.
Yeah. So on that one, we're looking at like 50, 51. And that's the first, and I just met these guys. And they've been helping me out. So it's just connecting with people, bringing value, and everybody working together.
Awesome. Let's see here. So besides the business and everything like that, I mean, what is your why? Like, why did you want to start doing this, make a big change, be about action, and start making a difference? Like, what is your why? What's your reason?
My why is now I have a new why, which is my baby girl.
There you go. You got a family.
But it's always been my family.
Yeah.
Seeing people around me do good and changing others' lives, as far as if it's from helping somebody out to something small or something making a huge impact in somebody's life. But my why's always been my family.
Right.
My family. Now I'm thinking my why's are actually growing and getting stronger and bigger. But it's always been my wife, my parents, my brothers and sisters, and creating opportunities for them. I've seen these guys provide for their mom and dad and family, create jobs and opportunities, and that's exactly what I'm gonna do. I used to compare myself to so many people doing deals and doing this and that, and like I would just always tell myself my time is coming, and it's coming fast, and it's coming strong. So I feel like it's now, and yeah.
Yeah, I mean, for me myself, you know, I always have this quote where it's like, continue to cheer on others until it's your time, because you will have your time eventually, right? You putting in the work, putting in that action, and then you will receive that result. So that's mm-hmm. really cool. I like that, because I know here and all of us on the team, our motive is always like our family, and we're very like tight knit, you know, and everything like that. So that's really cool. That's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. So super thankful for this event. I'm going to be there. You can say I've met great people there. I'm making money with people I met at previous events. So it's a no-brainer.
Awesome. So I know that we helped you move a deal. I wanted to talk about that a little bit. Mm-hmm. Would you recommend the Dispo Sharks to help out people with their deals? You know, because that's what we do here is we help move deals and find buyers and all that good stuff.
It was actually going to be my first deal. I sent it to Rodrigo. I sent it out to a few people, nobody wanted to pick it up. We're actually going to close. That was going to be a $32,000 deal, but for some legal reasons with title, it didn't happen. But it was pretty nice. As far as they've been able to help a bunch of my buddies move their deals and stuff like that. So
yeah, awesome. Yeah, so that's really cool. Yeah, I mean that's what we do here, and that's kind of what we want everybody to know. Like, we are here to help. We actually have result, right? Because we helped you move your deal. So that's super cool, and we appreciate that. You know, giving us a chance to do what we do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Real deal, like Ramon says, no fluff.
And yeah, no fluff here for sure.
Yeah. 100%.
So we'll be seeing you on Saturday then.
Yeah, I'll be there. See you guys, see everybody there, whoever's on this live, or get to meet people, man. Like just talk to people, shake people's hands, get their phone numbers, whatever you gotta do, but just everybody needs to work together, connect. Make some money.
Yeah, most definitely. I mean, we're all here to make money, network, and change lives. So I want to thank you, Manny, for joining me on the live and being one of the first to do our podcast for the Dispo Shark. So want to thank you again for joining.
Thank you guys for all the help and for everything you guys did for me. I appreciate
it. Awesome. Yeah, well, have a good one. Thanks so much.
Yeah, take care. Peace out.